Okay. And that was
1-2-1.
1-2-1. Here we go. All right. Very short, too. Yes. Okay. Prayer for relief from contempt. A song of ascents. Lift upon you, I lift my eyes, O you who dwell in the heavens. Behold, as the eyes of servants look to the hand of their masters. I think we just talked about that earlier. As the eyes of the maid to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God until he has mercy on us. For we are exceedingly filled with contempt. Our soul is exceedingly filled with the scorn of those who are at ease, with the contempt of the proud. Yeah. Guilty. Okay. So, there's so much to talk about, and I'm just sitting here going like, well, let's just kind of like peel back things slowly here. And does anyone here believe in coincidences? I know I don't. But, you know, if you do, well, you know, just tell me how this all fits together as a coincidence. So, 2019, booming market, everything's fine. A lot of troubles, a lot of people trying to, kick our president out of office. None of it's working. January rolls around. It's an election year. Suddenly, a deadly virus hits us from China. It's touted to be so deadly that about 2 million Americans are going to die. 2 million. It's kind of downplayed at first by the Democrats. They're telling you, just go out and live your life. This is all nonsense. Don't get so panicked. Next thing you know, people do start dying, mostly in nursing homes. And then it spreads out into the public. So the MSM fans the panic. Trump jumps through hoops, getting all sorts of medical equipment and testing and whatnot, and leaves the states to manage themselves, which was very smart. So people realize that flus come and go naturally, even though this one may not have, most likely has not, and Trump handled it well. So it's not working as far as they're concerned. Halfway through, let's just like pile things on. A cop kills a perp online in a liberal city. So the liberal mayor and the governor sit on it for 10 days while all the hatred starts going, and the MSM is, of course, fanning that hatred. Riots ensue throughout the Democrat cities who are doing nothing about it at all. Okay, so all precautions also preached for the flu, the deadly flu, for the 2 million people, all of it is ignored. So people are not social distancing, nobody's wearing masks, people are out doing whatever they're doing. Nobody seems to care. So that suddenly peters out about 2 weeks ago, and then all these fires break out in the West. And it's kind of interesting because it's mostly, the blue states that are burning. And it does not go north of the northern border into Canada, nor does it go south into the Mexican. So like, okay, so it's just in our country, and they're claiming, of course, global warming, but Europe, on the other side of the same hemisphere, is doing just fine. And all of a sudden, like, you know, we've got arsonists that are being arrested. So that's not working. Then, suddenly, 40 days out from the election, it is announced that Justice Ginsburg has passed. It's like, wow, that's a coincidence, isn't it? So it's like, again, she's been living the life of Joe Biden in the basement, rarely being seen and stuff like that. So, like, I've had my questions of whether or not she was even alive then. But nonetheless, we'll just go with what they do. All of a sudden, she dies. Now, at the same time, Biden enthusiasm is zero. Economy's bouncing back. And the polls, as inaccurate as they are showing that it's going to be a close race. She dies, and now, suddenly, it's not about Joe. It's not about anything. It's about abortion. Are we going to have a court that's going to abolish abortion? So now it's like, okay, they couldn't care less. They could have, you know, a five-year-old running as their candidate. Everyone's going to be voting for that. So my point with this whole thing today is that basically Christians need to vote. God does not have a political party, but the devil sure does, yeah. Because that other party is the one who is all for aborting kids. It's all for welfare. It's all for just like, you know, taking away our rights and basically being our overlords the whole time. So that's what it's all going to come down to. It's going to come down to basically, you know, are they going to get the enthusiasm going within their people to go vote? And are we, as Christians who apparently believe that thou shalt not murder innocent life, that maybe this is the time to say, okay, you know what, I don't vote usually, or maybe I wasn't planning on voting, but now it's time I have to vote because I either believe in innocent life living or innocent life being killed.
Yeah.
And it boils down to that, period.
Yeah.
So anyhow, the emotion behind the whole thing about abortion, it's crazy. I did an opening probably about a year and a half ago, which was basically about my having been involved with an abortion. And it was, to this day, it haunts me. And like, you know, I've been married happily for 40 years. This happened probably about 7 years prior to that. And like, you know, to this day, how old would those kids have been? What's, you know, what have I done? I murdered somebody. You can sidestep that all you want, but like, you know, that's what it is. And thank God for Jesus, and thank God that he saved me, and thank God that I can talk about it and say, look, don't go down that path. This is what it's going to be all about this November. Get out and vote for the party that is for life and not for murder. And that's about all I have to say today, but I might bring it up again. Who knows? I got 40 days. Anyhow, Lord Jesus, just thank you so much for our ability to communicate to not only the folks in this church, but globally with our church, little church that's spread far and wide. And Lord, we all do believe in you, your word, and the fact that there are evil forces in this world. And yes, some decisions are tough, but the right decision is always made with your word and guidance in mind. And Lord, we do pray for those that are hurting. We'll hear of some today from Charlie, but we all know plenty of people that are hurting at this point in time for a variety of different reasons. And I just pray that all those that are hurting know you as their Lord and Savior, so they can hang on to that promise and go through any problems here, trials. And those that we know that are hurting, that definitely do not know Jesus as the Lord and Savior, may this trial that they're going through be the stimulus for them to turn and consider and make the correct choice for you. And Lord, we just, pray for a good service today. Charlie's digging in back to Deuteronomy and how good that'll be, because it's such an important book, and it's cited quite a few times in the New Testament, so we'll find out why. And we pray all this in your son's holy name, Jesus. Amen. All right. Well.